but we established that you guys live on different coasts. Now, you know, being in a relationship, a long distance one, sometimes the distance is really good. It's good to miss your partner, but how does the distance affect your relationship? Is it good or bad? And Rodney, why don't you take this one first?
Well, I think it's good and bad. I mean, you know, it's a good thing because like you said, when we get to see each other, it's, you know, the passion is there. The passion is there. But sometimes, you know, when you're apart, it's like, you miss, you know, your other half. And, you know, it gets lonely sometimes when, you know, we're apart. So thank goodness for, you know, electronics, you know. So we get to, you know, we get to Skype and see each other quite a bit, you know. But it's not still like that physical touch. But, you know, it's good when we see each other.
Thank God we're not writing letters back in the 1800s that we need to get to each other, right? I always say thank God for technology. But you two had kept your long-distance relationship pretty much secret up until this point. Desiree, why did you decide to do that?
I decided to keep my relationship a secret because I wanted to make sure that it was real. I wanted to make sure that it wasn't just a fling or, you know, just something where we're going to be together for 2 or 3 months. It doesn't make sense to introduce someone to my family like that, you know? Yeah. So that's why.
Yeah. And Rodney, how did your friends and family react when you revealed your relationship with Desiree? Were they supportive?
They was very shocked because I don't talk about my personal life really with anyone. And, you know, when I told my friends and they found out, they was like, wow, you know, how can you keep this from us? But, you know, they was very shocked. And of course, they was very happy for me. It's happy for us as well. But they was very shocked.
And Desiree, what about your friends and family? How did they take it?
Because I'm a very private person, they took it like, oh, my gosh, like, who is this guy? Like, if he could deal with you, oh, my gosh, he must be amazing.
That's good. I'm glad you guys have the love and support of your friends and family. And, you know, Desiree, in the trailer, we see you getting upset that Rodney doesn't even post you on his social media, even though you both are pretty private people. And it seems like his family isn't necessarily on your side here. Are you nervous that Rodney might not be ready to settle down?
No, seriously, because that thought has come up, you know, it has come up. So, I mean, he's an only child. He's mama's boy. I'm just putting it out there. He is a mama's boy, you know, and I mean, he's proud of being a mama's boy. If you ask him, he's like, so what, you know, but I see where it is causing problems in our relationship. And it's just like, well, not my friends, not all of my friends, you know, are on board. You know, some of them have this, you know, they're skeptical, you know, why we kept the relationship so private. And, you know, I've mentioned him, but, you know, he hasn't mentioned me. Pretty much my friends and my family, they know everything about our relationship. I'm an open book. I don't believe in keeping secrets. And, you know, so, I mean, they know the good and the bad. And, you know, with that being said, it's just like, you know, it's some issues. You know, there's some issues with his family. You know, I mean, his mother has a real close-knit, you know, watch on Rodney, put it that way.
Yeah. Fair enough. And, you know, you're the new woman in his life, so there might be competition there with his mom. But Rodney, I'm just going to ask you flat out, my man, everyone's watching. Are you ready to settle down?
We've talked about it and, you know, we have things that we still need to work out first. So once we work everything out, you know, I am willing to move forward.
Okay. All right. This is a good teaser for the season. I hope you guys do work it out. Super cute. Now, Desiree, in the trailer, you storm out at one point. We see this happen. What can you tell us about this? And did you just hit a breaking point? Did you just get so frustrated that you wanted to walk out? Walk me through it.
Okay. Well, I've discovered being with Rodney that I have anger management issues. Yeah. And it's like he brings the beast out of me because I really love him. So it's just like, things that he does, he really gets to me. He gets that nerve, you know, that festivity nerve. So it's just like, I don't know how to control that. It's because, I don't know, for so long I've been asking him to introduce me to his parents, to his friends. It's like I was a big secret. So if we're moving on and someone is telling you that they love you and they want to marry you and they see a future with you, then why not come out and tell everybody? Why are we keeping our relationship a secret? So I was just fed up at that point. That's what it was all about. Yeah.
And listen, I know I can't give too much away here, but I do have to ask, Rodney, can we expect to hear wedding bells anytime soon?
You gotta watch the show.
Uh-huh. I almost had you. I don't know. Spark between you two and good smiles going on. So I'm hoping for the best here. Rodney, Desiree, thank you so much for being here today. And people, don't forget to watch season 2 premiere of Marrying Millions tonight on Lifetime at 10/9 Central.